Let's take our next question, that is question number 25. Now this question belongs to section of mechanics from chapter kinematics. So there are bullets which can be fired from the guns A and B with muzzle velocity 1 km per second and 2 km per second respectively. From the point on horizontal ground, they are fired in all possible directions. The ratio of maximum areas covered by the bullet fired by the two guns on the ground is. So this can be considered as a projectile where the bullets are being thrown or being projected at an angle of theta with the horizontal. What would be the condition for maximum range or maximum radius? That would be 45 degree. So for a case of projectile, maximum range would be given by u square by g, and we are well aware of this fact, right? So the ratio of maximum areas covered by the bullets, let's see. So area covered by first bullet would be pi r1 square, and area covered by the second bullet would be pi r2 square, where r1 and r2 are the ranges of these projectiles. Let's take the ratio of these. What I will get is a1 by a2 would be equal to r1 by r2 whole square. So instead of r1, I can write u1 by g, or u1 square by g, here u2 square by g, and its whole square, right? On solving, you will get a1 by a2 is equals to u1 by u2 whole power 4. So it's 1 by 2 power 4, which is equals to 1 by 16, right? Let's see which is the best suited option. So among these four, option number 4 is the right answer to this question, right? Let's move on to next question, that is question number 26. Now here, parallel plate capacitor, this belongs to section of electrostatics, that is electromagnetism. So parallel plate capacitor is of area 6 cm square and has separation of 3 mm. The gap is filled with 3 dielectric materials of equal thickness with dielectric constants 10, 12 and 14. The dielectric constant of material which when fully inserted above capacitor gives same capacitance would be. So in this case, let's consider this as positive terminal and this as negative terminal. So this can be treated as this case. So it's basically the parallel combination of three capacitors C1, C2 and C3, right? Now, if I want to form a single capacitor in place of this, so this would be the single capacitor. Distance between the plates will remain as it is, which will be remaining D. Only the area will be here, that would be 1/3, instead area will be here as A. So let's start with solution. So this, let's take this as C net. So C net we want would be K equivalent, which is filled by this dielectric K equivalent, into area epsilon naught by D, right? And seeing to the combination, it's simply the parallel set. So I'll write C net is equals to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Now you will get here as K equivalent A epsilon naught by D would be equal to K1 A epsilon naught by 3D plus K2 A epsilon naught by 3D plus K3 by 3 A epsilon naught by D. Further solving this, I'll get K equivalent is equals to K1 plus K2 plus K3 by 3. When you put down the values, you will get K equivalent as 12. Let's see which is the best suited option. So among these four options, option 3 is the right answer to this question. Let's move ahead with question number 27. Now this question here belongs to chapter current electricity and section of electromagnetism. As per the question, a uniform metallic wire has a resistance of 18 ohm and is bent into an equilateral triangle. Then the resistance between any two vertices of triangle is. So in here, this was the wire of resistance, or let's say length was L and resistance was 18 ohm, right? Now this was converted into a triangle. So every side was of L by 3 right? Let's take this A and this as B. This is the plus point and this is the minus point. So resistance of every segment, let's take this as C as well. So resistance of AC equals to resistance of AB equals to resistance of BC will be simply 18 by 3. As area of cross section is remaining same, length is getting divided. So it is 6 ohm. So the net resistance between A and B can be made as like this. Right? So from this side, there were two resistance, 6 and 6 in series, it becomes 12 ohm, and this one remain as 6 ohm. So R net would be equals to 6 into 12 by 18. That would be 4 ohm. Right? Let's see what is the net resistance we can obtain here. Out of these four, option 1 is the right answer to this question. Let's move ahead and see our next question, that is question number 28.